Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Deltona High School class of 2015. Ladies and gentlemen, before I begin, I respectfully request that all guests refrain from any activities that would interrupt or distract in any way from the dignity and significance of these proceedings. Thank you. At this time, please remain standing for the presentation of colors by the Deltona High School JROTC under the direction of Lieutenant Colonel Moore LeBon and Sergeant Major Middleton. Casey Carbonell, our Student Government Association President, will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Parents and friends, please remain standing after the pledge for the national anthem, which will be sung by the senior members of the Deltona High School Chorus, and also remain standing as the color guard exits the stage. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Boy.
You may be seated. School Board Chairman Costello, Vice Chairman Wright, distinguished members of the Volusia County School Board, Superintendent Mr. James Russell, senior staff, invited guests, family, and friends of our graduates. It is an honor and privilege to welcome you this morning and to present to you 354 seniors who have fulfilled the graduation requirements established by the state of Florida. This morning, the Deltona High School community is beaming with joy. As I look over this sea of blue, I see a class that is both special and unique. Their uniqueness stems from their numerous accomplishments as a class and as a result of individual academic and extracurricular accomplishments. They have set high expectations and met many of them, causing future classes to take notice and hopefully motivating them to try to surpass what they have done. And what they have done is remarkable and noteworthy. Let me highlight a few of the outstanding accomplishments of the class of 2015. 78 will graduate today with an honors designation, which signifies that they have attained a cumulative GPA of 3.5 or higher. 20 of those graduating with honors are graduating with a GPA of 4.0 or above. 3 have already received their AA degree. The class of 2015 has been awarded over $2.4 million in scholarships, a record for Deltona High School. The list of colleges and universities to which these students have received admission stretches from one end of the country to the other. 71 have qualified for industry certification, 22 are candidates for the Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, 20 graduates will honor their country by serving in one of the branches of the military. This class has also amassed 19,265 community service hours, and many graduates have received other academic, athletic, citizenship, and performing arts accolades throughout the year. These accomplishments were highlighted in order to confirm just how unique this class is as a whole, and yet the accomplishments noted to give credibility to just how special each graduate is individually. Class of 2015, since beginning your education journey some 12 or 13 years ago, much has changed in our society, in the world, and on the education front. You and I both have had to adapt to an increased focus on technology. As a matter of fact, your generation has experienced technology in ways we never imagined. The fact that you are master web designers, bloggers, tweeters, Facebookers, Googlers, and oh yes, texters, is an indication of just how rapidly the world around us is changing. Where technology will take us in the next decade is unimaginable. I pondered over how I could convey my words of wisdom to you this morning, and so I decided that since technology is such a huge part of your lives, I would encourage and hopefully motivate you in a technological way by offering a few helpful apps for you to download. The first app that I want you to download is the Grow app. Graduates, no matter what path you decide to take from this day forth, it is imperative that you seize every opportunity made available to you to improve your knowledge and your skills. What better day than your graduation day to commit to becoming a lifelong learner? Ralph Waldo Emerson reminds us that unless you try to do something beyond what you already have mastered, you will never grow. You see, globalization and the rate of information flow in this present time will cause us all to shed outdated information and force us to relearn to stay relevant. Graduates, you must grow. I have expressed to the past four graduating classes, For if we cease to learn, we cease to grow. And if we cease to grow, we cease to live. The next app for you to download is the app called Perseverance. I admire this class greatly because I know that you have already persevered through many changes just in high school alone over the past 4 years. You've taken on difficult assignments, experienced various grading practices, rigorous testing, ever-changing graduation requirements, and rigid college acceptance requirements. I implore you to maintain this same level of perseverance and resilience as challenges will come. But be encouraged, graduates, because sometimes it is only with adversity that we even have a chance at greatness. Never succumb to adversity, but yet allow adversity to become your opportunity. You see, determination is a wonderful trait. More than any other trait, it will empower you to achieve the goals you set before yourself and to have the life you dreamed of. And the most awesome thing about determination is, unlike talent, luck, and brain power, determination is what you can choose to have. The final app that I encourage you to download is the app Give. I've heard many times before that to whom much is given, much is required. Graduates, you have been given so many tools to help you succeed. These tools for success have been given to you by your parents, teachers, mentors, coaches, family members, and peers. Now it's time for you to go forth and set the world on fire by using these tools to ignite your creativity, innovative ideas, research, and volunteerism. Anne Frank reminds us how wonderful it is that nobody need wait a single moment before beginning to improve the world. Class of 2015, our nation is depending on you, for you truly have the power to do great things. Writer Edward Koch once exclaimed, "Although it's not the 4th of July, the fireworks begin today. Each diploma is a lighted match. Each one of you is a fuse. Graduates, light up the world by giving back." Class of 2015, this is certainly a wonderful moment for you. And as for your families, this is their day too, because they have traveled this road with you. After today's ceremony, take the time to thank everyone who has encouraged, motivated, and given you unconditional love along the way. This is truly a memorable day for our seniors, and I know that for the parents, family members, and friends assembled here today to salute this outstanding group of graduates, this will be a day that you will treasure for a lifetime. It is a day to celebrate and rejoice. However, in order for this ceremony to maintain the dignity and respect that this occasion deserves, I am asking that you refrain from using noisemakers, whistles, air horns, and to allow each graduate and their families the opportunity to hear their name when called. Finally, graduates, I could not be more happy for you than I am today. I believe that a prosperous future is on the horizon for each of you. It has been an honor and a privilege to serve as your principal and to watch you progress and succeed. And so in closing, class of 2015, always remember to live, to laugh, and to love. And for the final time, I say to you, and as always, go Wolves!
Good morning, everyone. It is my pleasure this morning to introduce our distinguished platform guests. To my left, Mrs. Linda Costello, Chairman of the Volusia County School Board, representing District 4. Ms. Ida Wright, Vice Chairman of the Volusia County School Board, representing District 2. Mrs. Linda Cuthbert, School Board Member, representing District 3. Mr. John Hill, School Board Member, representing District 1. Mrs. Melody Johnson, School Board Member, representing District 5. Mr. James Russell, Superintendent of Schools. Mr. James Tager, Deputy Superintendent for Instructional Services. And to my right, Dr. Robert Mall, Deputy Superintendent for Financial and Business Services. Mrs. Dana Page Pender, Assistant Superintendent of Human Resources. And Mr. Gary Marks, Area Superintendent. I would also like to acknowledge Mayor John Mazarek in the audience. It is now my privilege to invite Mrs. Melody Johnson, Volusia County School, representing District 5, to bring greetings from the Volusia County School Board. Following Mrs. Johnson, Mr. James Russell, Superintendent of Volusia County Schools, will give a few remarks.
I was told to be a really cool speaker and parent, we have to do a selfie, so here we go. Good morning to honored guests, parents, family members, and especially soon to be the graduating class of 2015. Today is a special occasion for you seniors because, like an autobiography, this chapter in your life is about to close. It is a chapter that was filled with grades, sporting events, school dances, after-school activities, short-lived crushes, and just hanging out with your friends. Your educational journey may not have always been easy, but the rewards, I hope, were very satisfying. In fact, if I may quote Beyonce, when she said, "If everything was perfect, you would never learn and you would never grow." Hashtag Beyonce knows education. Learning and growing in school has been a major part in your life. You've studied, written reports, read your textbooks, completed your homework, listened to your teachers most of the time, taken numerous tests. Boy, have you taken the test. But just like in any book, the pages of life are now about to embark in a new chapter. This new chapter in which you are the author can truly impact your world and our world. You're now holding the pen to write the upcoming chapter. You will soon be handed the opportunity to encourage, embolden, and empower your generation. When you step from here, you will encounter a world that may throw challenges your way. But when you overcome, the rewards will be oh so gratifying. I want you to look around, see the faces in this auditorium. Why did I ask you to do that? Because each person in this auditorium matters. In the age of iPhones, Wi-Fi, Twitter, Netflix, Instagram, these are just tools that are part of you, but it is not you. Even though this technology is what you depend on daily, it should not rule you. It is not what you should view as the most important feature in your life. The most meaningful part of your life should be the people who you can inspire and be inspired by. Your life should not be about the new cutting-edge technology or who has the number one song in America this week. It should be about love. Love is a starting foundation. It's also a strong foundation. With love, you can create an atmosphere where beliefs are accepted, diverse views are welcomed, and innovation is appreciated. Don't hold back and don't let anyone hold you back. Be who you are, and not a caricature of someone who wants you to be. Be real and authentic. Be someone who listens intently. Be someone who speaks with conviction from the heart. Be someone who is selfless and self-sacrificing. Reach out to those who have walked the path previously and seek their guidance. Learn from other generations so your footsteps will blaze a trail for those who will one day extend their hand to you. So I urge you to write this new chapter in your life with confidence and courage, character and compassion. It's the new chapter you should be reflecting on in what you do in your life, where you want to go and who you are as a person. Now is the time to achieve your dreams and make them a reality. Momentarily, you will leave here and the adventure will begin. Just like famous inventors and explorers from the past, those who currently are making history remain focused on their target. Run the race, climb the mountain, cross the oceans, but don't look back. The eyes of the world are watching, and they are also waiting. Your time is here, your time is now, It's time, graduates from Deltona High School, to begin writing this new chapter of your life. On behalf of the Volusia County School District and School Board, I congratulate all of you today and express my fondest and heartfelt wishes to the graduating class of 2015. Go Wolves!
Good morning, platform guests, faculty members, parents, families, and of course, the class of 2015. During graduation ceremonies, it has been a tradition for each speaker to give their best advice to the graduating seniors, advice that hopefully you will find useful in the future years. In preparing my remarks for this class of 2015, I gave serious thought to the message that I wanted to convey. For over 30 years, I have studied successful people. Some of those individuals I have read about, others I've only heard about, but the vast majority I have met in my Wolfgang life. Most of these individuals are neither famous nor wealthy, as the world would define it, yet they were successful as they had defined it. Each of these people had a goal, a passion, and many of them described it as a burning desire to achieve what they wanted to achieve in life. The most dominant trait that all of these individuals possessed was personal initiative. Some of them told me it was self-motivation. It is that ability to judge what needs to be done and to take action. Every graduate here today has demonstrated personal initiative. You wanted to graduate from high school, and you fulfilled the requirements to do so. Across this district, I've had the pleasure of meeting hundreds of members of the graduating class of 2015 at award ceremonies, academic fairs, banquets, and in the classroom. There is an incredible work ethic in this class that has been manifested in numerous ways, such as taking advanced courses, dual enrollment, mastering music, excelling in athletics, JROTC, FFA, the arts, the academies. There's been incredible stories of resiliency in this audience as well. There's been members of this class that have suffered hardship, sadness, and suffering. Yet, they persevered and they are graduating. The class of 2015 has demonstrated the spirit of volunteerism. For this reason, your willingness to serve should be commended. 230,962 service hours have been accrued across this district by the 10 graduating classes of 2015. A work ethic, perseverance, and volunteerism are traits that are driven by self-motivation. So now my question to you is this: what do you want to do with your life? How will you make that happen? Stephen Covey, the writer of 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, wrote, "The key is taking responsibility and initiative." Deciding what your life is about and prioritizing your life around the most important things. I was going to end by saying the iconic Latin quote, carpe diem. Last Sunday, I Googled, what is the story behind that Latin quote, carpe diem? And I learned that it's actually much longer. In Latin, it's carpe diem quam minimum credulo posterior. Translated, it means this: seize the day, put very little trust in tomorrow. The Roman poet Horace is telling us that the future is unknown, therefore, we should do all we can do today to make tomorrow better. In other words, it is the responsibility of the individual to be self-motivated, resourceful, and enterprising in their own life. Graduates, you have demonstrated personal initiative, and I challenge you to carry that trait forward as you build your future. In closing, congratulations to each of you, and I wish you much happiness and all the best that life has to offer. Thank you.
It is my distinct pleasure and honor to introduce our student speakers this morning. Our first speaker is Olivia Naboa, the senior class president. She will be speaking about the upcoming journey for graduates. Our second speaker is Casey Carbonell, and he will be speaking about the exciting challenge for the future. Our third speaker is Corey Love, and he will be doing a speech on tolerance. Ladies and gentlemen, Olivia Naboa.
Good morning, class of 2015. Family, friends, faculty, honored guests, and speakers. If you think back on our last 4 years in high school, it's like a river. Along the way, we faced some bends and curves, picked up some trash, went against the flow, and followed the path of the stream. It was a long ride, but overall, it was unforgettable. Do you remember walking on campus freshman year and seeing those gum-filled sidewalks, or being told that there was a swimming pool on top of the gym? And that we would get dumped into trash cans on freshman Friday. We all started out gullible and naive, but if we made it through swag and YOLO, I promise we can make it through anything. We have created bonds with one another that helped us get through our high school years, special bonds that could never be broken. There is no bond stronger than those made through eye contact with someone during a test and seeing the struggle in each other's eyes. We've bonded throughout the stressful times during the year, like senior exits and finals. But we've bonded throughout the fun and memorable moments, like grad bash and prom. One thing we made it through this year was being diagnosed with senioritis. Throughout our teachers' lectures, we'd fantasize about our futures, sometimes causing our grades to slip. But thank goodness for our wonderful proficiency model. We have waited 4 long years to gather our family and friends and sit beside 2 people we may or may not know. We have waited to hear our names called and to get our diploma and, as a class, move our tassel to the left. 4 long years filled with late night study sessions, Friday night football games, and tedious standardized tests. Now we're out of high school. A bell no longer decides where we need to be and what time we need to be there. Our days are no longer broken up into 55-minute intervals. And we no longer have to ask permission to use the restroom. We are now adults. We are prepared for the real world, whether that is to protect and serve our country, enter the workforce, or continue to further our education. High school has taught us the lessons necessary to succeed after graduation. We will now not wait until the night before to type a 5-page essay, or literally not judge a book by its cover. Now it's up to us to put those lessons into use. All our memories from the past 4 years have led up to this very moment, the moment we come together to celebrate our accomplishments. Now that we're on to the next chapter in our lives, we must follow our own stream. We may not be able to change the world individually, but if our class of 354 students works to their full potential, we will be closer to this goal. So my challenge for you and for me is to strive for success in all that we do. Although we have diverse plans for our future, remember, once a wolf, always a wolf. As Steve Jobs said, don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. Let that inner voice be heard. But today, let that inner voice chant 1-5 for the last time together. When I say 1, you say 5. 1.
5.
1.
5.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'd like to welcome our superintendent, Tom Russell, school board members, and our principal, Ms. Susan Freeman, whose leadership helped to guide the school. I would also like to welcome all the teachers without whom we would be well-rested and without stress. Also, our guidance counselors who have helped relieve the stress created by our teachers. I also would like to welcome the families of the graduates present here tonight who push us to succeed at our highest level. And last but not least, I'd like to welcome my fellow graduates. What's up, class of 2015? I'm truly honored to be speaking to you this morning. I don't really have anything important to say, so please bear with me. I remember walking into freshman year, being afraid of high school, intimidated by the gigantic seniors that seemed to stomp around the halls, intimidated by the daunting coursework necessary for success, and afraid that I wouldn't be able to handle the stress of high school. But what I quickly learned was that those giants were friendly and welcomed the freshmen with open arms. That with hard work and dedication, the coursework was manageable, and I was no longer afraid of my future. I feel the same way now about facing my future. I can only hope that my future will give the same warm welcome that Deltona High has given me. As I look back at my time here at Deltona High, I look back with pride. proud that I can say that I'm a wolf for life. I'm also proud to know that the faculty and staff have our best interests at heart and are invested in all of our futures. Although we are leaving the campus, we will still be in the minds and hearts of those who truly care for our success. I hope that each and every one of us realizes the honor that we have to be receiving not just a diploma, but a Deltona High School diploma. Isn't it crazy that it's finally over? Gone are the endless nights that you spent studying and cramming for finals. Gone are the hours and hours spent working on projects and homework, not to mention playing sports, participating in extracurricular activities, and working. Just kidding. The late nights and long hours are far from over. Just think, now you can start doing what it is that you want to do. I don't just mean the freedom that graduating high school will give you, but the freedom to start the profession that you want to work in. It gives you the freedom to be who it is that you want to be. That, in my eyes, is worth every minute. I wish each and every one of you success in the future, and I hope that you all stay trill. All right, fam, keep it 300. Go Wolves.
Hey, it's me, your valedictorian. You want to know something funny? I don't actually believe in this whole valedictorian system. I don't really believe that I should be up here just because of my grades. Since birth, I have been given opportunities that not everyone has. For most of my life, my family has been in the upper middle socioeconomic class and has been able to use money to foster my academic success. Whenever I needed a new calculator, my family could afford it. Whenever I needed money for a field trip, it was there. Heck, my parents even sent me to private schooling for 10 years of my life, because in the end, we could afford it. Now, this isn't to say that my parents didn't work hard for that money, because they did. But the fact is that the money my family had provided me with opportunities. This isn't the case for all families. There are families that can barely afford to feed and clothe their children. There are kids out there who have to get multiple jobs just to sustain their family. They aren't able to take all the AP courses that I can because they don't have the luxury of time that I do. No, they are born under different circumstances, and because of that, they couldn't be standing here like I am. So, to those of you who had to undergo unfavorable circumstances in your lifetime, this speech is for you. To those of you who have to work for their family's survival, this speech is for you. To those of you who had to feel the effects of racism and stereotyping in your lives, to those of you who are not heterosexual or are not cisgender and have had to deal with a family that does not accept you, those of you whose identity has been negated, this speech is for you. To my women out there who have been told that they are inherently less than men and that they have been called names for doing the same thing that men do, this speech is for you. To those of you who have ever felt subhuman because our society has told you that a superficial trait about yourself is unfavorable or abnormal, this speech is for you. Now, class of 2015, I ask you one thing, to love your fellow human beings. I ask that if you were to have a child, that you love it no matter what. And if you aren't willing to love your child, despite its gender, despite its sexuality, despite its possible mental or physical disabilities, then please do not have children. Humans are not clay that can be stretched and carved to fit your mold of what a human should be. Class of 2015, I challenge you. I challenge you to be tolerant and understanding. I challenge you to all just sit down one day and to think critically about how you treat other people. Do you treat them with kindness and with love? Or do you treat them with prejudice, shoving your privilege in their face until they can't breathe? I just challenge you to be progressive and to make this world a little more livable for those of us who have already been told that their lives do not matter. No matter how cliche it may sound, the future is in our hands. It is up to our generation to make a change and to make a difference. It is our responsibility as individuals to think about the things that we say and the social ramifications that they may have. It is our responsibility to know that humor is not a sufficient reason of being problematic. I cannot stress this enough, but jokes are comments that attack the vulnerabilities of an entire group that has been thrown at the bottom of our country's inherent power structure are never funny
and are always uncalled for. It is our responsibility to know this. It is our responsibility to treat others equally and as humans. Class of 2015, it is our responsibility to care. Thank you.
Thank you, Olivia, Casey, and Corey, for those inspiring words. At this time, I would like to invite Casey Carbonell to join me at the podium. It gives me great pleasure to recognize Casey Carbonell as the Class of 2015 salutatorian. Casey is graduating with a 4.5 GPA. He is the Student Government Association, Key Club, and Rho Kappa President, National Honor Society Treasurer, and a member of Mu Alpha Theta, National English Honor Society, and Echo Club. Casey is also a Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction Program participant, Medallion of Excellence recipient, a former Tomorrow's Leader, and was selected as the leadership recipient for the Deltona High Wall of Fame. He serves as an altar server at Our Lady of the Lakes Catholic Church and is employed by Planet Smoothie. In addition, Casey is a volunteer for Relay for Life, UNICEF, and the Joey Uvalde Soccer Tournament. Casey plans on attending the University of Florida and double majoring in health services and political science. Our 2015 salutatorian, Casey Carbonell. Thank you. I would now like to invite Corey Love to join me at the podium. I am honored to recognize Corey Love as the Class of 2015 valedictorian. Corey is graduating with a 4.6093 GPA. An outstanding student, Corey is president of the National Honor Society, treasurer of SGA, has served as vice president and treasurer of the International Thespian Society, is a member of the academic team, a superintendent's diploma of distinction program participant, medallion of excellence recipient, AP scholar of distinction, and was voted Mr. Deltona High School. Corey is also involved with the Athens Theater of DeLand and has volunteered with Girls on the Run Breast Cancer Walk, Winterfest, and Homecoming. In addition, Corey works as a light and sound technician at the Deltona High School Auditorium, and I am pleased to announce that Corey received a letter of commendation from the National Merit Scholarship Corporation. Corey plans on attending the University of South Florida to double major in chemistry and chemical engineering. Our 2015 valedictorian, Corey Love. At this time, I would like to acknowledge Mrs. Mary Jo Norsha and Mrs. Janine Coslow, who will be conducting the senior roll call for the distribution of diplomas. I would ask at this time if the members of the school board and district administrators would join the Deltona High School administrative staff for the awarding of diplomas.
Hello?
This isn't on.
I don't think this is on.
Shirley?
I don't think this is on. Wait, yeah, it is. Hello?
Test?
Yeah.
Angel Acevedo, Samantha Magdalena Acevedo, Christian Acosta, Scholar Cum Laude, Lenishka Soel Avrant Lorenzo, Patricia Nicole Aguilera, Merit Scholar, Isabel Alexander, Dakota James Allman, Joshua R. Almodovar, Merit Scholar, Jacob Michael Alonso, Joely Alvarado, Kayla Kennedy Alvarado, Merit, Janelle Yvette Alvarado, Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, Kiana Renee Anthony, Chris Arce, Scholar, Cum Laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, Nicholas Rafael Arenas, Merit, Ashley Denise Argueta, Gabriel Nicole Ashmead, Scholar, Liana Grace Ayala, Peter Joel Ayala, Sam Backus, Earl Francis Bailey IV, Jordan Lee Ray Barger, Jaisha Brianna Barnes, cum laude, Kayla Lynn Bevins,
Josie Catherine Bermudez, Liani Berrios Figueroa, Miles Best Merritt, Janelyn Betancourt Erbolini, Merit Scholar, Alicia Biagetti, Merit Scholar, Evan Christian Beer, Sarah Marie Black, Tyler Michael Bosford, Merit Scholar, Eden Botner, Magna Cum Laude, Haley Jade Bowers, Daniel Devante Brennan, Mark Austin Hippolito Brighella, Scholar, Chad Teron Brown, Chasimi Teray Brown, Nicholas Michael Brown, Freddie C. Bryant Jr., Megan Victoria Bull, James Jamal Byers, Adeline Magali Cabrera, Merit Scholar, Magna Cum Laude, Jordan Nathaniel Cadavid, Aileen Camacho, Jasleen Kimberly Camara Duran, Richard Logan Kamek, Alfred Leo Cambo III,
Ashley Marie Cancel, James Michael Capps, Scholar Cum Laude, Eduardo Cardenas Jr., Akeem Siobhan Carr, Brittany Lee Caraturo, Crystal Josette Carrera, Merit, Bianca Ines Cassiano, Kira Lynn Chapman, Jason Matthew Siafi, Merit Scholar Cum Laude, Alyssa Ann Clark, Sarah Victoria Cole, Laura Ann Coleman, Merit Scholar Summa Cum Laude, Ariel Asia Edith Colon, Cum Laude, Mark Anthony Colon, Scholar, Jennifer Nicole Conrad, Scholar, Haley Alexis Cooper, scholar, summa cum laude. Shalea Naomi Cornelius. Caitlin Christine Cornetto, merit, scholar, summa cum laude, superintendent's diploma of distinction. Carol Maria Cortez. Tierra Nicole Cotton. Alexis Simone Cruz. Jenna Ippolito Cruz, merit, scholar, summa cum laude.
Julian Noah Cruz. Thalia Andrea Cruz. Stephanie Carolina D'Amato. Kendrick Alexander Daniels. Shakenya Nichelle Daniels. Kristen Morgan Davis. Alexis R. De Jesus Cortez. Tatiana Jeanette De Los Santos. Dalton Lee Decker. Angelina Cheyenne Delgado, merit, scholar, magna cum laude, superintendent diploma of distinction. Erica Joreles Delgado. Julian Gabriel Delgado. Cheyenne Dallas Demers, merit, scholar, summa cum laude, superintendent diploma of distinction. Jomar Ezekiel Deschamps. Denisha Lachey Diaz. Crystal Irene Dominguez, merit. Mark Andrew Donahue, merit. Mary Lou Francesca Duque, merit, scholar, magna cum laude, superintendent diploma of distinction. Demira Dwight. Alexander Erke, merit. Ryan Elbert. Jonathan Ernesto Elorga Jr., merit, scholar, summa cum laude, superintendent's diploma of distinction. Rose Marie Enos.
Ashlyn Gail Evans, scholar, cum laude. Zachary Peter Ewers, scholar, magna cum laude, associate of arts. Tamia Monica Feliciano, scholar. Jordan C. Fernandez. Felicia Marie Ferrante. Asia Shakoya Farrell. Joseph Patrick Ferreira, merit. Sara Ana Maria Figueroa. Jonathan Caleb Finley. Ashley Nicole Flownery. Jerome Malik Ford Brown. Giovanni Alexander Fratacci. Carmen Lizeth Funes Malta. Travis Marks Gabriel Jr. Jose Luis Gallard. Isaiah Emmanuel Galarza. Justin Devin Galbraith, scholar. Cindy Garcia Reyes. Cristian Luis Garcia. Mirelisa Garcia, merit, cum laude. Camila Garcia Medina, scholar. Hilares Giselle Garcia Milan, summa cum laude. Ashley Marie Gash, cum laude.
Kelsey Barbara Gerchens, merit, magna cum laude. Kirsty Nicole Gilbert, scholar, cum laude. Jade Zandia Gilman, scholar. Justin Angel Gines. Gladys Rufina Gonzalez. Isaiah Quentin Gonzalez. Jose Luis Gonzalez. Joshua A. Gonzalez. Stephanie Crystal Gonzalez. Chelsea Mackenzie Goodwin. Bryant Goris. Peter Justin Goris, merit, scholar, summa cum laude. Marissa Aaron Gosh. Dylan Greer. Tiana Jade Greer. Gabrielle Alyssa Grinstead. Maria Alessia Guerrero Marquez, Scholar, summa cum laude, Superintendent Diploma of Distinction. Jonathan E. Gutierrez. Morgan Heather Hackett, Merit Scholar. Tyler Reed Hallmark. Jonathan Richard Hamlin. Megan Lee Harper. Kenneth Harris.
Khalid Jael Hawkins. Carter Christopher Hayes. Robert Carl Helmick. Timothy James Helmick, Merit. Shaniqua Arnia Leslie Herbert. Kelsey Marie Hinshaw. Susanna Elizabeth Holland, Merit Scholar. Morgan Elizabeth Holmes. Haley Marie Hobus, Scholar. Jennifer Jane Huber, Scholar Cum Laude. Michael Anthony Ingracia, Merit. Jennifer Elizabeth Intagliata. Rachel Ann Jeanette, Magna Cum Laude. Sharquicia Anquinice Johnson. Brett Robert Jones. Jeremy Thomas Jones, Merit Scholar. Ariana Garnett Jones Chrissy, Merit Scholar Cum Laude. Jasmine Margaret Joseph. Kyle Eugene Judkins. Nicole Can. CJ Kenya. Christopher Ann Kiefer. Alyssa Marie Kelly. Pedro Kelly. Zachary Jacob Kleindorfer, Merit Scholar.
Victoria Ann Kopersky, Merit Magna Cum Laude. Logan Eugene Kolka, Merit. Genesis LaBoy Rivera, Summa Cum Laude. Sarah May Lake. Alicia Leone LaRoche. Boston Thomas LaRussa, Scholar, Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction. Melanie Ann Lyson, Merit, Scholar, Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent, Diploma of Distinction. Brianna Lynn LeMay. Tyler Patrick Leonard, Merit, Scholar, Summa Cum Laude, Associates of Arts. Justivia Shire Lewis. Corinne Elizabeth Litchford. Michaela Marie Lallman. Audris Lucia Lopez, Scholar Distinction. Christian Lopez. Sophia Cristal Lopez. Brandon James Lowe. Gabriel Shalom Hosea Macklem. Sierra Ann Mackey, Scholar, Magna Cum Laude. Brianna Kaylan Malave. David Antonio Maldonado. James Anthony Malishka, Merit, Scholar, Cum Laude. Christina Lee Mann, Scholar, Magna Cum Laude. Brittany Manny.
Darnell Elisanor Marseille. Kevin Travis Marsh. Bobby Charles Martin. Alicia Jezebel Martinez, Cum Laude. Peter James Martinez, Scholar. Rachel Francis Martinez. Bryden Garrett Matthewman, Merit. Janice Daniel Matthews, Scholar, Summa Cum Laude. Brittany Lorraine Mavitz, John P. May, Tori Devante Mayo, Eric McKay Jr., Melissa Lynn McLean, Diamond Trevesha McMillan, Ainsley Albriana McPherson, Scholar, Melissa Kyla Meager, Estemarie Medrano, Kimberly Lisa Mena, Sydney Maria Mercado, Merit Scholar, Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction. Sarah Ann Miracle, Scholar, Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction. Sierra Janet Miller, Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction. Ciara Paige Mondell, Leslie Nicole Montañez.
Justin Luis Morales, Catherine Morales, Rashawn Andre Morgan, Nicole Marie Morose Merritt, Kyle Alexander Mornian, Robert Allen Moen, Mari Angelis Munoz Miranda, Ryan Michael Masori, Matthew Jacob Meyerski, Scholar, Brian Joseph Nieves, Cum Laude, Nijah Marie Nieves, Nelson Alexis Nieves, Melissa Danielle Noel, Miriam Neshwat, Merritt, Wyatt Odin, Merritt, Edwin Jerry Ojeda, Jonathan Nomar Ortiz, Kylie Joe Otway, Ricardo Raul Pagan. Nicholas Alexander Pappas, Merritt. Derek Matthew Parent, Scholar. Matthew Deshaun Parker, Cum Laude. Stephen J. Parker. Madeline Brooke Pasley, Cum Laude.
Tyler Alyssa Paula. Jared Matthew Piatic, Merritt, Magna Cum Laude. Valeria Francisca Peguero, Scholar, Cum Laude. Elise Leonor Peralta. Joel Percival, Merritt. Elaine Michelle Perez. Kaina Atali Perez. Anthony Michael Peterson. Elizabeth Anna Marie Phillips, Scholar, Magna Cum Laude, Associate of Arts Degree. Saquin Somchai Phipps, Merritt, Scholar, Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction. Angela Marie Paizo, Xavier Deshaun Polk, Stefan Justin Rode, Andres Eduardo Ramirez, George Anthony Ramos, Scholar, Magna Cum Laude, Austin Adair Rasmussen, Scholar, Magna Cum Laude, Ryan Scott Reich, Merritt, Scholar, Brittany Marie Rebels, Scholar, Magna Cum Laude, Sydney Leone Rue, Merritt, Scholar, Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction, Brianna Nicole Rivera, Merritt, Dayanis Rivera, Emmanuel Rivera,
Erica Alexis Rivera, Janelle Amaris Rivera, Karina Rivera, Merritt Cum Laude, Kayla Nicole Rivera, Scholar, Natalia Rivera Velez, Gracheles Rodriguez, Justine Marie Rodriguez, Merritt Scholar Cum Laude, Bianca Rodriguez Lara, Merritt, Angelis Rodriguez Garcia, Cum Laude, Eric William Romeyer, Merritt Cum Laude, Ileana Dominique Romero, Merritt Scholar, Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent Diploma of Distinction. Tatiana Rosario, Merritt. Jamira Shante Ross, Scholar, Magna Cum Laude. Diamond Rafaela Roussakos. Ashley Nicole Rudd, Magna Cum Laude. Brittany Ann Rudy, Scholar. Christian A. Ruiz. Marcos Samuel Sanchez, Scholar Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent Diploma of Distinction. Pamela Sanchez. Brutania Farley Sanon. Calino Santiago Cum Laude. Luis Santiago Jr. Cum Laude. Christian Jabal Santos Jr. Merit.
Anastasia Dawn Schilling. Jenny Lee Segarra, Merit. Ivan Seeger, Merit. Ryan David Serafine. Christopher Michael Serrano, Magna Cum Laude. Jacob Weston Sexton. Ashley Marie Shaw. Muhammad Ali Arsalan Sheikh. Cody Parker Chanette. Ashley A. Skaggs. Lawrence James Smiley Jr. Raven Heather Smith. Jose Gilberto Soto Acevedo. Samantha Diana Sparks. Brittany De Jesus Steele. Jose Manuel Suarez Ayala, Merit Scholar. Sarah Caitlin Suttle. Amber Sue Taft. Jonathan Willard Tainter Jr. Austin J. Taylor, Merit. Megan Kelly Teggy, Merit Scholar, Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction.
Brianna Thompson. Jalen Jarrell Thompson. Jenna Elizabeth Thompson, Merit. Nicole Lynn Torres. Victor Jared Torres. Jose Raul Torres Feliciano. Ashley Marie Vargas. Charlene Nicole Vasquez. Jacqueline Elizabeth Vega. Victor Vega Jr. Carlos Joel Venizario. Sean Anthony Berg. Kayla Marie Vickers, Merit Scholar, Magna Cum Laude. Veronica Nicole Vidal, Merit, Magna Cum Laude. Louis Walker, Scholar. Courtney Alexis Wall, Scholar, Magna Cum Laude. Shaprina Kanisha Washington. Anthony Jordan Wineclaw, Cum Laude. Olivia Renee Williams, Merit. Amanda Nichelle Wallerman. Stephen Edward Young, Magna Cum Laude. Anna Luz Zambrana, Merit Scholar, Magna Cum Laude, Superintendent Diploma of Distinction.
Robin Danielle Sawatsky. Olivia Ann Marie Noboa, Magna Cum Laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction. Casey Mitchell Carbonell, Scholar, Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction. Corey Evan Love, Scholar, Summa Cum Laude, Superintendent's Diploma of Distinction.
Class of 2015, please stand. Seniors, it is with great pride and by the power vested in me by the state of Florida, the school district of Volusia County, I now pronounce you graduates of Deltona High School. You can move your tassels from right to left.